What's going on, my PT peeps and my Walking Dead family? Welcome to the PT channel. I'm One Eye Bry. You don't know if I'm winking or I'm blinking, but I'm definitely thinking about The Walking Dead. And in this video, I'm going to cover the picture right here, My Family by Judith Grimes. There's a whole sequence about it, the Whisper Alpha new video that's going around, the teaser trailer, and the Whispers as a whole. So obviously, spoiler warning for the show, the comics. If you're worried about spoilers, stop watching now, as I don't want to ruin anything for you. I'm going to talk about Negan, the Whispers, and a bunch of things. So obviously, spoiler warning. But first, guys, if you can, show us some love by hitting that subscribe button if you haven't already. If you have, like and share and let your friends know about the channel if you can. That would be greatly appreciated. Photo credit and info credit to these fine folks right here, and giving credit where credit is due for sure. And if you follow The Walking Dead on Instagram and Facebook and a bunch of other places, The Walking Dead posts this nice little video. Well, I have pictures to break it down, but ultimately it's My Family by Judith Grimes. She draws herself, then Carl, then Mom, then Dad, then Alexandria, and it's a whole sequence. And you can see it changes. And if you want to see the whole video, follow us on Facebook at the PT channel and TWD community. But you see it changes. Judith is wearing the hat and Carl has an X and it says, ouch. Kind of interesting. There's an X right there, right? The X's are showing up more and more. Carl goes away. She draws the bridge blows up. And it's the sequence of Carl being there, then Carl being gone, the bridge being there, Dad's gone, Michonne and Judith are still there, and you see the sequence of things. Pretty interesting, right? But we'll see to the very end, very interesting. The bridge blows up, and even though Judith wasn't there, I'm sure Michonne told her. I would think that Michonne would tell her the truth, or the truth according to Michonne, because she thinks Rick is gone, even though he's still alive. I can't wait to see them get reunited. You can see the subtle change. Dad is gone, the bridge is gone. Now she has the gun, the hat, and the gun. Pretty cool stuff. I think it's a cute little sequence and it happens super quick. It's just a little storytelling of Judith's story. Remember, she never really met Lori. Michonne has really been Judith's mom. She's been there since she's been able to remember things, I would assume. And clearly Judith sees Michonne as her mother, which I do like. I like to see that on the show and I'm glad it's happening that way. And then at the end, we see RJ and everyone's smiling. Pretty interesting because RJ is in the picture. And I know a lot of people don't think RJ is real or RJ's alive. He could be alive. He might not be alive. He's probably alive. I know a lot of people are one way or the other about it. They're like, what about Magna? What about Carol? They said this, they said that. Everyone needs to relax. It's just a fun discussion point on this channel, at least. Our story continues and hurry up. February 10th, 2019. I'm excited to see how the story continues. You can see the picture right there hanging in Michonne's room. You can see Dad, Mom, me, Carl. It's basically that whole concept there of the evolution of Judith's story. And I think it says Judith, but it's clearly Rick, Michonne, Judith, and Carl. And I think we'll see this in episode 909 when Negan goes into the house. And then eventually we'll see Michonne and Judith at Carl's grave in Alexandria. Not sure when we'll see this, but it's clearly not when Rick was around. You can see the haircut of Michonne, what's going on with that. I can't wait to see how it unfolds. The back half of season 9 should be great, and I'm very, very excited. How about you? Then we see the big news about Alpha. Yes, this is Alpha as confirmed by The Walking Dead. You can see the hair, the mask, the look. It's Alpha. I'm excited to see how Alpha talks, how Alpha walks, how Alpha is portrayed on the show. I believe Samantha Morton will do a great job, and it looks creepy. I shared this picture on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter, and a lot of people are like, man, that is creepy as, that's for sure. And I'm excited to see how it plays out. I think this is another Whisper. It's not Alpha. Is it Lydia? I can't tell by the skin on the mouth or on the finger, but it could be Lydia, but it's someone with brown eyes, and it's definitely different from Alpha to the other Whisper. But we're going to see Lydia most likely in episode 909. I hope to see Alpha in that same episode. Maybe we got to wait until episode 910, but I would think we're going to see Alpha pretty much right away. So we'll probably see Lydia first, then Alpha, then Beta. But these look great, and I'm very excited for the horror element coming back to the show. We haven't had a scary, creepy horror aspect to The Walking Dead probably since the first or second season, as the show changed showrunners in a different dynamic. But we see from a teaser trailer, we see Alpha. That is a good shot of Alpha sewing up her mask. And if you check out AMC's YouTube channel, you can see the whole 30-second clip. But you see Alpha sewing up a mask and sewing up this. And it goes from sewing up the mask to moving the mask. And it's pretty cool. It's kind of creepy. Like I said, it's only 30 seconds. But it's definitely Alpha sewing up her mask and talking about whispering in a creepy way with a creepy song, and it's pretty cool. I want to see more of a horror aspect, and I think the whispers are a great way for that to happen on the show. And then Alpha puts the mask on and throws the hair back, and I guess someone ties it or something there, but ultimately it looks awesome. It is a great early sneak peek teaser trailer of Alpha. I just think it's going to be awesome. The whispers are going to be awful. They're going to be great and terrible at the same time. And when I say awful, they're going to do awful things. The whispers should look great. I think K&B effects are going to do a great job, because basically the whispers look like walkers without the full makeup and the black eyeshadow and black makeup between the skin. So you'll see part of the person's skin underneath the fake walker skin mask, which should be awesome. It's probably going to be hot on the thing too. So maybe she sews it up and it's tight, so then she can just slide it on. I think that's the way it goes. Or maybe someone's got to tie it up for her. But ultimately, the whispers are here. And when you just look at this picture, you see the bright blue eyes, that's for sure. But the whispers are a crazy bunch. They have this view of survival of the fittest. Anything kind of goes. Alpha lets the whispers and beta do whatever they want. And it's kind of barbaric and archaic, and it's pretty terrible. And I wonder how they're going to do that on the show. But Alpha looks great there. The comic variant cover has her with a white mask kind of skin there. And I know it's just a comic variant cover, but it looks kind of too clean and too nice for her walker skin mask, because it should be gross and dirty, because they live in the woods and they're always outside. They're not just hanging out in some community. They're always out and about in the woods somewhere. But ultimately, the whispers should be awesome for the show. And I think that's a great shot from the comic. And you can see that Alpha is going to be a complex character. She's tough, she's fearless, but she's also a human being. She's a little crazy with her mindset, especially with her daughter Lydia, that we'll see on the show most likely. But you can see a great shot there of Alpha and Lydia. This is most likely when Alpha gets Lydia back. And we're probably going to see that on the show exactly like this, but you can see the outfit that Alpha and Lydia are wearing. And Alpha's outfit is basically that same one there. It looks exactly the same to me. And I wonder what they're going to keep and what they're going to change and what they're going to remix, what they're going to twist, what they're going to turn. I want to see how it goes down. I can't wait for February. Hopefully you're very excited as well. We're getting there, guys. We're getting closer and closer and closer. And remember, Alpha is a woman. She's kind of a small, petite, little woman. Samantha Morton is 5'3", Ryan Hurst is 6'4", probably with boots on, it'd be close to 6'6". So Alpha should be small and Beta should be big, but Alpha is the leader and Beta is the second in command. But Alpha is bald and she's a woman. I believe Samantha Morton did shave her head, or at least has a haircut like that. We see Alpha on the left and Samantha Morton on the right. And this is probably around the time when they wrapped for filming, and I believe Samantha Morton is going to look like that, because we did see her in the trailer with a haircut basically like that. So I'm excited to see how Alpha walks, how Alpha talks, and how the whispers come to town and they come to the hilltop and Alexandria and eventually see the Whisper of War. And I've been getting a lot of questions about the Whisper of War. And for those who don't know, that's the big event after the other big event of the Pike lineup. But I believe the Whisper of War will probably be season 10. But Alpha's coming to the hilltop to get Lydia. And in the comics, Alpha interacts with Maggie and Rick. And they're both gone. So is she going to interact with Michonne and Daryl? As we're definitely going to see Daryl interact with Alpha, because that's what's happening right here. You can see Alpha at the gates. You can see Daryl walking to go talk to her. And what's going to happen with this? Are we going to see this happen right here? Negan and Alpha? I think it's going to go down somewhat like this. As the early word from the spoilers and everything going around is that it happens a lot like the comics. So we'll see how it goes down with Negan and Alpha. And if you know the comics, you know the big, big event that happens between these two. So there you go, guys. There's a lot of information going around, but not enough to settle our need for The Walking Dead to fill the void. Hurry up, February 10th for sure. But we have little pictures coming out, some information, some first looks, some other stuff. And once we find out information, we always share it with you guys on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube, of course. We're at the PT channel. Let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. Are you excited for the whispers? Alpha, Beta? When are we going to see RJ interact with other people? I want to see that for sure. Let me know your thoughts. Like I said, post your comments below. Like, share, subscribe if you haven't already. Show us some love by hitting that subscribe button. And remember, guys, with hard work, dedication, belief, and sacrifice, you can truly achieve your goals. Believe in yourself. You can do it. And tell them, Daryl.
Yo, we love you guys.